And here is the Writer's Almanac for Wednesday. It's the 15th of April, 2020. It was on this day, 1802, William Wordsworth, walking home with his sister Dorothy from a visit to their friends, the Clarksons, on the shore of Ulswater in the Lake District of England, saw a patch of daffodils that became the inspiration for one of Wordsworth's most famous poems. Dorothy wrote in her journal, "When we were in the woods beyond the park, we saw a few daffodils close to the waterside. We fancied that the lake had floated the seeds ashore and that the little colony had so sprung up. But as we went along, there were more and yet more, and at last, under the boughs of the trees, we saw that there was a long belt of them along the shore, about the breadth of a country turnpike road. I never saw daffodils so beautiful. They grew among the mossy stones about, and about them some rested their heads upon these stones as on a pillow for weariness, and the rest tossed and reeled and danced and seemed as if they laughed with the wind that blew upon them over the lake. They looked so gay, ever glancing, ever changing." William was impressed by the daffodils, too, but he did not write his poem, "I Wandered Lonely as a Cloud," until about 2 years later. And it's the birthday of the novelist Henry James, born New York City, 1843. Famous for his long, complicated sentences, such as this one in The Wings of the Dove. He wrote, "It was the accident, possibly, of his long legs, which were apt to stretch themselves, of his straight hair and his well-shaped head, never the latter neatly smooth and apt into the bargain, at the time of quite other calls upon it to throw itself suddenly back and supported behind by his uplifted arms and interlocked hands, place him for unconscionable periods in communion with the ceiling, the treetops, the sky." Virginia Woolf wrote that sitting down to tea with Henry James, you waited for him to finish a sentence as a farmer might wait for the hen to lay an egg, shifting from one foot to the other. It's the birthday of Bessie Smith, born in Chattanooga, 1898. A little kid, she sang and danced on the street corners for coins. She was discovered by the blues singer Ma Rainey, who took her on the road with her. And a decade later, 1923, Bessie Smith's first recording, Downhearted Blues, sold more than 2 million copies in the first year alone. She recorded 150 songs with Louis Armstrong, Fletcher Henderson, Benny Goodman, and many others. And here's the poem for today, the poem by William Wordsworth that he was inspired to write on this day in 1802. "I wandered lonely as a cloud that floats on high o'er vales and hills, when all at once I saw a crowd, a host of golden daffodils, beside the lake, beneath the trees, fluttering and dancing in the breeze, continuous as the stars that shine and twinkle on the Milky Way, they stretched in never-ending line along the margin of a bay. 10,000 saw I at a glance, tossing their heads in sprightly dance. The waves beside them danced, but they outdid the sparkling waves in glee. A poet could not but be gay in such a jocund company. I gazed and gazed, but little thought what wealth the show to me had brought. For oft, when on my couch I lie, in vacant or in pensive mood, they flash upon that inward eye, which is the bliss of solitude. And then my heart with pleasure fills and dances with the daffodils." William Wordsworth's poem, "I Wandered Lonely as a Cloud." That's the Writer's Almanac for Wednesday, April the 15th. Be well, do good work, and keep in touch.